So you're going to Miami. Whether you're a seasoned pro or a sunseeker visiting the city for the first time, this insider's guide will have something to whet your appetite. Miami is a young city with barely 100 years under its belt, but this southern gem has packed a lot into its short history. After being flattened by the great hurricane of 1926, Miami rebuilt itself by embracing all that's new, from Art Deco to the body beautiful. And as a result, Miami is one of the world's premier playgrounds, with an abundance of fantastic beaches, cool hotels, great restaurants, and flashy nightlife. You may be dazzled by Miami's veneer of sunny glamour, but this city has so much more to offer, from its blossoming art scene, thriving neighborhoods, and swathes of unspoiled parkland. Miami is an impressive patchwork metropolis that's knit together by an intricate network of freeways and causeways. So the best way of getting to know this tropical gem is by getting to know the neighborhoods. And there's no better place to start than at Miami's party capital, South Beach. Located on the southern tip of the massive sandbank that is Miami Beach, South Beach is why most people come to Miami, and it's easy to see why. With its gorgeous beach, endless year-round sun, great shopping, an incredible array of Art Deco buildings, this is one of the hippest hoods in all of the U.S. The best way to start your day on South Beach is with an early morning jog in the Florida sun. Or if you're looking for something a little more zen, why not stop by the Orange Lifeguard Tower at 3rd Street on the beach for a daybreak yoga session. South Beach Yoga have classes every day at 7 a.m. and all are welcome. It's an ideal way to cleanse your aura after a night on the tiles. All that lotus posing will work up an appetite. So there's nothing better than treating yourself to a bagel breakfast at the News Cafe. This 24-hour cafe is a local landmark and is usually very busy. But it's best to wait for an outside seat to fully appreciate the menu. And more importantly, the people watching. South Beach may be famous for topless joggers and beautiful sunseekers, but it's also got an impressive cultural pedigree in the form of the historic Art Deco District. This district is made up of a whimsical collection of more than 800 architecturally protected buildings from the 1930s and 40s, and is the largest concentration of Art Deco architecture in the world. It stretches from 5th Street to Lincoln, but the best thing to do is to drop into the Art Deco Welcome Center on Ocean Drive and take a guided tour. They take place daily and offer a great insight into the colorful history of this neighborhood. After your culture fix, there's nothing better than a spot of retail therapy to focus the mind. And your first port of call has to be the Lincoln Mall. It's a magnet for shopping and entertainment, with a great range of upscale stores and a huge variety of bars and restaurants. And if you really want to push the boat out, why not head a few blocks north along Miami Beach to Bal Harbor Shops? This mall is continually ranked as one of the most prestigious shopping meccas in the world, and offers an unrivaled range of designer boutiques from Gucci to Louis Vuitton. Downtown Miami is just a 15-minute drive from Miami Beach, but it's a whole world away with its soaring office towers and ultra-modern high-rise condominiums. The area is the hub for international business and finance. But if you take a look around, you'll find that this neighborhood has got a lot more to offer. Take a stroll down to Bayside. It's a thriving marketplace full of trinket shops and improvised entertainment. And if you're feeling that distinct Latin vibe, why not join an impromptu samba session? And while you're at Bayside, why not hop on one of the ferries and take a cruise along the scenic Biscayne Bay? You can take in the views of downtown or spot the celebrities on the mega-rich Star Island. Downtown may be famous for high finance, but it's also home to some of the city's best children's attractions, including the tropical theme park, Jungle Island. The park has a huge array of wildlife, with everything from tigers to penguins. And there's also a petting barn where children can feed the animals. There are shows every day, including the flying condor, and a reptile show with a giant python. Just across the MacArthur Causeway from Jungle Island is Miami's very own Children's Museum. This playful-looking building is home to 14 different galleries full of interactive exhibits, including the Castle of Dreams and the World Music Studio. There are also art classes provided by the museum's full-time artist-in-residence. This museum is so much fun that it's even been known that adults join in with the kids' activities. For a true taste of Hispanic culture, you should head to Little Havana. This neighborhood is the symbolic heart of Cuban Miami, and is filled with quirky shops, great restaurants, and the sounds of salsa. Take a stroll along the popular stretch of 8th Street known as Calle Ocho, and drop into one of the many cigar shops that line the strip. Here you'll find artisans still hand-rolling cigars in the tradition of Cuban's finest. If you want to take a time out, there's nowhere better than Maximo Gomez Park. This tiny lot on the corner of Calle Ocho and 12th is where the locals come to play dominoes, smoke cigars, and argue about politics all day long. If your wander through Little Havana has worked up an appetite, you're in for a treat at Café Versailles. This kitsch chandelier and mirror interpretation of its French namesake might give you indigestion, but don't be fooled by the decor. This is where all of Miami's Cuban bigwigs come for the best in Cuban cooking. Miami is fast becoming one of the most exciting cultural destinations in the United States, and it's nowhere more evident than in the Design District. This neighborhood has been transformed from a rundown warehouse district into a thriving creative hotbed with glamorously refurbished buildings, glossy stores, and impressive galleries. The Moore Building is an old furniture factory that's now an exhibition space, hosting many touring gallery shows. It's also home to the gravity-defying Zaha Hadid installation, Elastica. The streets are dotted with high-end furniture stores and exclusive boutiques, including Maison Martin Margiela and Thomas Mayer of Bottega Veneta fame. The newest addition to the neighborhood is the impressive De La Cruz Gallery, which was built to house the collection of the De La Cruz family. This is one of the many galleries that open their doors late for the Evening Art Walk that takes place the second Saturday of every month. Just down the road from the Design District is the new kid on the art block, and her name is Wynwood. This neighborhood has an edgy vibe, but has seen a huge influx of artists and galleries attracted by the area's newly established art scene credentials and ample exhibition space. One of this district's founding tenants is the Rubel Family Collection. This gallery was opened in 1994 in a former Drug Enforcement Agency warehouse and is recognized as the pioneer of the Miami model, which is where private collectors create a gallery space and open it to the public. This Stark warehouse is the ideal location to display the Rubel family's vast art collection. It is, in fact, the largest private collection of contemporary art in America and includes works by Cindy Sherman and Jeff Koons. Wynwood is also famous for its murals, which are randomly dotted around the neighborhood. Some recent additions include a mural by the artist Shepard Fairey, who created that famous stenciled portrait of Barack Obama. And after you've walked the art walk, there's nowhere better to grab a bite than at Joey's. This little Italian eatery has the best pizza in town. No cultural tour of Miami would be complete without including the diverse collection of museums on offer in this tropical metropolis. And one of the most interesting examples has to be the Vizcaya Museum and Gardens, just north of downtown. This opulent villa was built in 1916 as a winter retreat for the agricultural industrialist James Deering. This millionaire was fascinated with 16th century Italian art and architecture, and scoured Europe for historical interiors and artifacts to create his dream mansion. It took $15 million and 1,000 artisans almost 5 years to complete, and the result is a thunderous clash of Baroque, Renaissance, and neoclassical fixtures and fittings that is a grand statement of excess. However, the real triumph is outside, with the fabulously landscaped gardens full of fountains, period statues, and decorative urns. Another Miami cultural gem is the Wolfsonian Museum on South Beach. This museum was originally formed from the incredibly diverse collection of propaganda and advertising art donated by movie theater millionaire Mitchell Wolfson. Over the years, the collection has evolved and is now dedicated to art and design from the modern era, with a fascinating array of objects and art, including zany works by the likes of Charles Eames and Marcel Duchamp. After a day out in Miami, you'll probably be feeling a bit peckish. So it's a good thing this city has a culinary reputation that's hard to beat. If you take a stroll along South Beach's Lincoln Mall, you find a huge array of restaurants, of which Sushi Samba is undeniably the best. This New York import has settled in very nicely in Miami and offers an inventive mixture of Japanese, Brazilian, and Peruvian dishes. This restaurant has a real buzz, whether you're sitting inside with the funky decor and DJ, or out on the terrace. Try the Samba rolls for the liveliest sushi you've ever had. Or why not satisfy your cravings for Latin cuisine by heading to D. Rodriguez, Cuba, at the Astor Hotel. This restaurant is run by local culinary legend and self-professed king of ceviche, Doug Rodriguez. He's a real character, and it comes across in his groundbreaking food, which is at the forefront of the Nuevo Latino cuisine movement, otherwise known as the Mango Gang. His dishes are ambitious, and above all, delicious. If you're spending your evening in the Design District, there's nowhere better than celebrity chef Michelle Bernstein's Señora Martinez. This great tapas restaurant is situated in an old post office building and serves small plates of really big flavored food, styled after the famed tapas of Andalusia. If you want some intellectual stimulation after your evening meal, you should head to a concert at the Adrienne Arsht Center in downtown Miami. This colossally impressive building was designed by architect Cesar Pelli and is home to the Florida Grand Opera and Miami City Ballet. The center also has many performance spaces that host musicals, touring theater, and stand-up comedy. So you'll be guaranteed to find something that suits your taste. Or you could go to a concert at the New World Symphony on South Beach. This renowned orchestral academy was founded by Michael Tilson Thomas and manages the tricky task of being highbrow but yet totally accessible. The orchestra's performance space is a wonderful Frank Gehry creation, where they present everything from mixed media extravaganzas to free student concerts. But if you want to explore the bar scene, there's nowhere better than Miami's Party Central, South Beach. The nightlife in this neighborhood is a high-octane contrast to the lazy days on the beach, with everything from the uber-trendy hotel bars to an old-fashioned dive bar. If your wallet is flush and you want to live it up in this Playboy's paradise, you should head to the Sky Bar at the Shore Club, or drop in for a cocktail at the hipster hangout that is the Delano. And if you want to hit the clubs, just head down to Washington Avenue and party into the early hours. After your night out, you'll want somewhere to rest your weary head, and Miami has plenty to offer, from high extravagance to more modest lodgings. White Law is a great little Art Deco hotel in the heart of South Beach, just a block from the Atlantic Ocean. Its location is perfect for all you bright young things, as all the big clubs are within easy walking distance. And with free cocktails in the lobby bar every evening, there's no better place to get the party started. It's a fun hotel with cheeky decor, funky furnishings, and a laid-back atmosphere. The rooms are cool too, with an all-white interior that manages to be both homey and plush thanks to some nice attention to detail. If you're staying downtown, you should check out the Urbana. It's a cute little boutique hotel that's in the heart of the financial district and within easy reach of all the downtown hotspots. The Miami art scene has clearly influenced the interior decor, and there are works by local artists exhibited throughout the hotel. The rooms have all the mod cons for a busy business traveler. But if you want to mix some business with pleasure, why not head down to the pool, chill out in a cabana, and soak up the rays? For the ultimate in destination spas, you have to head to the Canyon Ranch. This hotel is perched on the edge of the ocean along Miami Beach and is a tower of sumptuous grandeur designed to revitalize and rejuvenate. The rooms are more than generous, with many having amazing views of the beach and beyond. But it's the spa that takes center stage at this luxurious temple to the body and soul. It has a state-of-the-art gym and a choice of over 40 different fitness classes a day, including Kinesis sessions and a chance to scale the hotel's very own climbing wall. And after your workout, you can relax in the Aquavana Thermal Suite with its tropical showers, Finnish saunas, and eucalyptus igloos. For the ultimate in rest and recuperation, you can't beat the Canyon Ranch. If you want to escape the hustle and bustle of Miami for the day, why not grab your clubs and head to Doral? This massive resort has 5 golf courses to choose from. But the most famous and challenging is the USPGA Championship course, Blue Monster. Or if you want to go further afield, you should drive down to the Everglades National Park. This waterlogged prairie covers over 2 million acres and is one of the world's most diverse ecosystems, with alligators and crocodiles being its most famous inhabitants. And the best way to view this habitat is by dropping into the alligator farm. This farm offers entertaining and informative reptile shows daily. But the highlight has to be the fast and furious airboat ride. It is truly one of the most exhilarating trips you're ever likely to experience. After the adrenaline rush of skimming over the glades, you'll have earned a Robert Is Here smoothie. They are the freshest, tastiest smoothies in all of Florida. Miami is a city full of character. Outrageous and stylish, fun and very cool. This is the town where you come for the sunshine and stay for the party.